In 3D computer graphics, we usually use a Cartesian coordinate system. In this system, we have an origin and three direction vectors called x, y, and z. The origin is some fixed point in space whose location everyone agrees on. This point can be anything. I could build a world based on a location of a surveyor's marker, a dot drawn on a tablet, or a reference point I simply imagine. For example, if I'm designing a great new teapot, I don't really care where the rest of the world is located. So I could state that my origin is just a point in empty space. I might then build up the teapot's model so that this origin point is in the center of the bottom of the teapot. Here's a prettier view, since I want you to see the 3D coordinates better. The three direction vectors define the axes of the coordinate system. They are normally each perpendicular to the other. That is, the angles here, here, and here are all each 90 degrees. It's possible to define a coordinate system with axes that are not perpendicular, but this is rarely done in practice. For example, finding the distance between two points becomes a tricky concept when the axes are not mutually perpendicular. Given an origin and three vectors, we can then define the location of any point in space with a triplet of numbers. For example, this point has a triplet of 2, 3, and 4. It has its 2 units along the x, 3 along the y, and 4 along the z. 3D vectors are described by a similar coordinate reference system, except that the origin is not needed. A vector describes a motion, which again can be described by three numbers. That is, it describes how far to move to get from one point to another. However, this movement is not fixed in any particular location in space. To understand the difference, think about time. A specific time is like a point. An amount of time is like a vector. It specifies a duration, but no starting time is given.